Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best and Slot, and tonight we are going to try for the first time Dark and Light, a new RPG game came out about a week ago. Been absolutely blowing up all over YouTube, probably because it's got a little bit of ARK in it in terms of stuff, but it's more fantasy based. You know, we've got dragons, we've got monsters, we've got ogres, we've got spells, that kind of stuff. It looks really, really cool. I've only just got hold of it and figured it's a side. Hey, let's do some fun stuff. Let's give it a go. We are going to play on our own map. Let's turn that one on. Why not? Play single player, let's go. I don't really know anything about the game at all. I've tried to avoid, shut up world, I've tried to avoid all information about it. I want to go in this completely fresh and just kind of enjoy a new game. Now, whether we keep playing this is obviously up to you guys down below, but I will say right now, let's say if we can get this video to 500 likes, 500, there we go. Wait, no, that way, right? 500, we will come back and we'll do another episode tomorrow, which would be Sunday. And usually that's my day off, so I'm just saying, I'm willing to sacrifice my day off for the sake of playing more video games. What a noble, noble gentleman I am, eh? Anyways, Dark and Light, let's go. Right, select faction. We've got three options here: Talos, Estelle, and Ironfast. Let's have a little read here. When humans first arrived on Archos, they struggled to survive and were shunned by the other races. With stubborn determination, Leondos Talos, maybe an Elder Scrolls reference, led his people west where they discovered an abandoned fortress on the coast surrounded by bountiful grasslands. Here he founded the city of Talos, where vowing that all people... I can't actually scroll down that. So, it's humans, elves, and dwarves, by the looks of it. I'm gonna go human for now, because I'm very boring. Okay, there's my man. He's a manly man, but we're gonna go female, because we tend to. People tend to get angry at me, but people should shut up. Detail adjustment, right. This is important stuff, by the way. People are gonna complain, but this is important stuff. Chest height, for example. You know, that is important, important detail. Chest size, important. It's all. I'm just gonna leave it kind of up a little bit. High, I'm just gonna, not even looking right. Shoulder width, why not? Neck length. She's got a slightly small neck. Who knows? Do I care about her arms and stuff like this? I don't think I do. I mean, this stuff is great for people who really wanna like really get into their character, but me, I'm gonna leave it alone. I do wanna change her hair though, because her hair is stupid. Hair, there we go. Presets, what have we got? I'm a big believer in ponytails in video games. It's a very weird thing to say, I'm sure. But every time I make a female character, that tends to be the way I lead. She has a very pointy chin. We'll go with that. Hair colour, wow. I can't do it. I like my characters to look good, so I can't go too stupid. I just can't bring myself to do it. Is that sad? I don't care. I'm just gonna go brown. Right, face. How do I change your face to be less pointy? It's too pointy. Chin length, chin angle? No. A little bit. We need to, like, chin location. What? Where can we move it? Oh my god, we can shuffle it. Look at that. Amazing. Forehead size, jaw width. If we pull that out a little bit as well. Bring chin length in. Just wanted to look a little happier, you know? A little friendlier. It sounds dumb, but people have like friendly faces or not friendly faces, and it's not really their fault. But to an extent, you feel like people who have not friendly faces, that then influences their later personality, you know? Does that make any sense whatsoever? Probably not. Chose sex. Okay, here we go. Bingo bango. Awaken, child of Gaia. I am Elysia, Archmage of the Order of Dark and Light. I transported you to Archos in hopes you can do something, because I talk too quickly. First, you must learn to harvest what you need to from nature to survive. Find some shrugs and strike them to gather useful items. If it's dark, open your inventory and use something to use the light. Tip, developers, with that kind of thing, let us skip it, you know? Don't do it for us. Right, so we need to harvest some berries, magic shards, and stones, and I need to go check if the sound is too loud or not. Game was actually a little bit loud. Right, let's go. Harvest berries, harvest... So, you... It's my inventory. This is quite cool, right? I've got a house! Wait, I don't think it's an actual house. We've got tasks, we've got quests and stuff like that. It is, it's kind of got... It's like a proper little RPG game, you know? However... And I'm sure other people have commented on this, but those are straight out of Lord of the Rings. Those, well, the Hobbit, right? Those hobbits are in the Hobbit. Pretty sure that's not legal, right? They are literally the hobbits from The Hobbit. Those two. I don't think any of the others are. And him, maybe. These two for sure, though, are from The Hobbit. Why are they in the game? That seems illegal. Hyenas, dragons, spiders, treants, goblins, piranhas, griffins, alligators, bears, boas. Oh my god, yes. I don't care if they're stolen everything from other games. If they give me awesome creatures like that. I guess this is where the game wants me to go, right? Sort of out into the wilderness to try and loot some stuff. Let's have a little look. Hello, human. God. Man. Yes. Okay, let's have a little explore, I guess. Hello, sheep. Are you a sheep? Can I harvest you? It's a wild sheep. And it's adorable! So it's actually kind of terrifying. I take it all back. You're not cute. You're spooky. I just saw something to harvest. Ah. Hua! There we go. Got some wood. About time. I need berries. I've just got a few berries. I've got some stones as well. Smash that bush to absolute shreds. Got myself some magic shards from that bush as well. Easy peasy this. Got some more berries. We don't actually need those. Ah! So I guess I'm just going to beat up some bushes. There we go. I just need stones. Wow. Well, I need a tool. Can we craft anything? Knowledge, maybe. Architecture. Make houses and manors and stuff. This is awesome. Okay, I can't do any of that yet, though. This is my only task. Harvesting. Yeah, let's just do that one. If it's dark, open your inventory and use the Rune of Light. Is that thing? Yeah. So we're just trying to get another stone. Maybe you don't actually have to spend points or anything. To increase this knowledge, harvest... Okay, that's pretty cool. So doing certain things. It's like Skyrim, right? Where you do certain skills and it levels up things related to those skills. Which I really like as a system. There we go. Craft Rune of Light. Okay. Okay. Knowledge. Schema unlocks. Task. Inventory. Aha! Schematics. So that needs three magic shardy things. We have enough of those. Boop! There we go. I've got 7 runes of light now. Cast Rune of Light. But it's so bright outside. Use. Ah, oh, it's a Tinkerbell. Eat berries. Okay, I can do that. All I do is eat. Alright. 1. Just shove them in your faces now. Rank up melee crafting skill. Always heat your stomach. If you allow yourself to go hungry, may I have food? Hello, beautiful. What do you want? You little weirdo. Access your knowledge and see what action is needed to reach. Okay, so where's melee crafting? Oh, and dark magic. What's unlock? Draining spell. Oh, I'm so excited. Right, so we want to try and unlock a stone axe. We need to harvest stones from boulders and craft stone weapons and tools to unlock our melee crafting rank. Slightly confused. Oh, I can level up stats. I don't know. Oh, I think I'm going to leave that alone for a little bit. I'm really, like, when it comes to RPGs, I really like to, like, min-max my character, you know, make it absolutely as good as it could be. Which is a problem, usually. Cast Rune of Light. I already did that. Ah. No. It seems like it wants me to cast Rune of Light. I'm just going to do it again. I'm not allowed to do it again, am I? No. Ah! What the? Chabow! 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 I just got absolutely slaughtered! Absolutely slaughtered! This freaking skeleton jumps me out of nowhere! Level 44! I think I can punch a tree. I'm gonna punch a tree. Hwah! Screw you, tree. It's my house. It's not actually... I got some apples! I wonder if that's doing it. Knowledge! Melee crafting. No. Harvest stones from boulders, but I don't think I can do that. Maybe I can punch the boulder. Let's go try it. Let's go find a boulder to smack. Stay away from spooky level 44 skeletons as well. Jeez Louise. I can't afford any of them, obviously, but it's good to know. Does anyone sell a useful one? No. Just giggling away like a mad woman. Aha, this looks more promising. Alright, that's an axe right there. I want the axe. No, I want the pickaxe. Oh, I can afford the pickaxe. Sweet. Maybe this is what I was meant to do. It doesn't actually feel like it is, but it worked the other day. Can't really complain. Oh, I can roll. Wait, if you do it forward, it's sprint. If you do it to the side... How the hell did I... How did I even do that? I just did it, and I've forgotten how already. Okay. But you can roll. Somehow, you can roll. Right. Anyways, if we harvest some boulders, that is going to get up our melee crafting skill. Yeah, that's the stuff. Ah, yes. Give me that sulfur orb, baby. Okay. Can I harvest this? I think that's a fence. Let's check if that is actually doing what I want it to do, though. It should be... Yes, there we go. 50% already. I think if we go blow up this little boulder over here... Sweet! Craft stone axe. See what I mean? Well, whatever. Craft stone axe. We can do that. Can we do that? Yes! I've got booties! Oh, did I get... Oh, I got all this from my character, didn't I? When she, you know, died slightly. Harvest apples, harvest wood. Okay, not a problem. Give me a tree. I don't think I get apples from beating on trees. I think I need to sheath it and punch. And that's going to give me the apples I need, yeah? Did last time. I like this little fairy dude. Rank up staff crafting skill. Okay. Have a little look. Where's that? Staffs. What do we need to do? Harvest magic shards from nature. So we need some lovely, delicious, nutritious bushes. It's kind of weird, right? That the game is so like ARK. You know, the berries are spoiling. We're ranking up by sort of doing little activities. There's a lot of crossover. And I'm just curious as to... Not how they justify it, because that's fine. But like, why is there so much crossover? Why are the systems... so similar. It's kind of like playing the Architect Project after you've played the Isle. You notice that the base, like, foundation of the game is exactly the same, you know? Is this actually leveling up? It should be, right? Not anymore. Why is that not leveling up? It's 66%. Now, I can't craft a stave, so all I can do is harvest magic shards, but I just did. I just harvested, like, 7 of them. I got bugger all. 2 upgrade point. The most delicious. I'm going to put some points in health. And... Oh, cool. Is that cool? I don't know. And a point in weight. Going for the arc route. I'm gonna attack a tree, see what happens. Maybe we get magic shards from a tree? Yeah, my staff still is going up. I think it might be mislabeled. Because that just went up when it really shouldn't have. But whatever. Not a big deal. It's my goal to craft a... Yes, craft a sorcerer's staff. We can do that. Dark magic rank 1. Cast a draining spell. Maybe I actually have to craft the spells. Ooh. I'm gonna hit him and try and get some experience points. No, he's level 76. I'm gonna hit him. No, it's a mistake. Hitting him was a mistake. Can I loot him at least? I'm gonna pretend I helped. What did I get? Got some fur. It's a furry skeleton, of course. So, I think the goal is to point my staff at a tree and click. Nice! Yeah, that's pretty cool, isn't it? Stupid tree. So we're like harvesting the natural resources. Need some stones. Can I just use my pickaxe and kind of cheat? Don't know why the game just wants to give me so much sulfur ore. I'm just gonna see if this goes up. Didn't actually get any stone from that. Oh, it's just bashing these massive boulders. Yeah, it does work, yeah. Right, there we go. Magic uses your mana. Where is our mana? I don't see it. Okay. Use the flowers. Delicious. Put them there. Bum. It's down here somewhere, right? Oh, it's the brain. It's the brain. Remember to always mind your focus. These gifts will offer some rest, but you need a source to hide it. Okay. The bond takes a great deal of magic. Experience is key. You must practice what you've learned and experiment to discover more. I'm quite excited to play this game. Gotta level up. One more time. I'm gonna put another point in health. I am actually starving to death here, so I'm gonna eat like a billion apples. Don't know how much that's helping, but it's probably helping. Okay. So, what do we want to level up? I guess we just go harvest some stuff and kill some things. Maybe, and just start leveling all the stuff up. Thaumaturgy, earth, magic, taming, farming, riding. Sturge saddle. Wait, what's the top one? Frost dragon saddle. Awesome. My hunger is yet again going down. It's very dark and spooky. I'm just gonna go harvest stuff. I guess that's the idea, right? If I just beat on things, eventually good stuff will happen for me. Alright, sounds like science. I'm getting over encumbered, so I think what we should do is go flog some stuff. I'm also going to cast another spell. It's getting a little dark and spooky out here, folks. Where's where's my fairy gone? I just cast a little bugger, it's disappeared already. Oh my god, down there, loads of creatures. What the hell are they? Let's go have a look. Am I going to be able to get back up? I guess we'll find out. It doesn't look like we're getting back up this way, though. Maybe that way, yeah. Oh, I can murder sheep now, maybe. Ow. It sounds bad, but whatever. Come here. You want my dinner, okay? Mwahaha. There we go. Oh my god, it's actually the same noise. Right, listen, 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 listen. I leveled up! That's what I needed to do. Sheep are the dodos of the dark and light world. What is that? A bramble hopper. That's like a little, weird little, soon to be dead thing. Come here! You can't hop away from me, you bramble hopping son of a gun. It's a rabbit! You are starving. Well, good thing I'm getting ready for this, isn't it? That's why I've got all this delicious meat. Sweet! I think I leveled up. I definitely did level up. Alright, we're gonna go back towards the fire. There we go. Still nothing here. I don't actually know what that's about. We're gonna go back to the bonfire and cook our meat, right? And try to harvest some berries as we go. The bloody rain's finally stopped as well. That's good. Stupid bramble hopper. Berries! Well, that's leveling up my survival and my water magic. It must be a bird. I keep hearing it. Aha, there it is. I'm gonna get my stick on, you know? Search. There we go. I guess that's cooking now, hopefully. Otherwise, God knows what else I'm meant to be doing. Points in attack. And wait. Are you cooking? All I can do is assume yes. Ah, no, craft. There we go. Okay. Phew! Right, okay. What is my task? Well, I should have done, yes, a new world has been completed. I guess I'm just gonna work through these. That one's completely done now. City Dweller. Harvest Twine. Harvest Sulfur Ore. Harvest Magic Shard. Well, I've done that many times. Meat? Meat! Delicious meat! Oh, that's the stuff. Look at that. Food meter fly up. It's amazing. Awesome. Awesome, 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 awesome. Can't craft anything new yet. What are these exclamation marks about? No idea. Bestiary, right. Has this, like, filled in at all? Because I've killed things. Let's just get rid of all the other ones. Yeah, look. Sheep! I've murdered sheep. And I've also murdered rabbit. Deadly spider, yeti, wyvern, wolf, wind. Oh, I just want to see all of them right now. Amazing looking creatures. And these are all the normal ones. Like, elites. Dark. Mythical. Own? Crystalline beast, wind rider, sacred griffin. Cool! What's that saying at the bottom? There are more than 150 creatures in this version. 150. Ah! It's so cute! Okay, well, I figured out the loading system, the selling system, and I feel slightly stupid, admittedly, for not getting it a little sooner. I'll just show you what it is. Basically, if we talk to Gunter here, basically, Gunter will buy 100 pieces of wood for 75 gold. If you don't have 100 pieces of wood, he will not buy the wood. So I can sell this and make an absolute fortune. What's this? Stone-tipped spear or throwing knives? I don't want any of those. But it's good to know how the system actually works for the first time. Will she buy anything from me? No. Okay, sorry, it's a large man, but whatever. This dude I just sold some stuff to a second ago. He sells like stuff that we can make a door, but I think I'd rather build my own. And apparently loads of these tasks don't actually work at all. So I'm not gonna worry too much about them. It's kind of just gonna be like a, you know, a general, here's something to aim for, you know? So, straw work. This is what I want to do. We want to build a house, right? Harvest straw from... harvest straw from shrubs, trying from trees, and build straw structures. Now, oh, we've got to be level 5. That's why these aren't ranking up. I guess. I didn't think about that. So we can level this one up. Ranged crafting, which I believe we need to get like a bow and stuff, which is important for taming. This is why my melee's not leveling up anymore, because we need to be rank 12 for the next one. It's all starting to make a little sense. Now, what is this gonna get us? A campfire. That is in our quests. So, harvest wood from trees. Let's just go do some harvesting and try to level that up. But we're gonna explore at the same time. You know, we're gonna wander off into the wilderness, level up our survival as we go, and see what happens. I am going to get the hang of this game, with God as my witness. I will get the hang of this game. I really like the idea. I really see Lara Croft every time I look at my character and it's freaking me out. Bah! There we go. Survival just went up. Easy freaking peasy. Some other stuff is going up as well. Water magic and stuff like that. Campfire. Now, I don't really care about that right now. So, oh, but I do have a task for it. Let's just focus on our knowledge base for now. So I can't level survival up anymore, we need one more level. I think we should focus on leveling up. Try to get level 5 and then we can build ourselves a little house. I think that's a good idea. So, sword out. Let's go find some stuff to murder, you know? I mean, we could build here, you know, just have a little fun in the village. I also need some water, so maybe we should head back to the ocean. I'm gonna have a little explore. What's this? Oh, it's for sale! Well, you can rent it. How much? Oh, you rent for 2 days. I'd rather buy it. I don't really want to rent a house. Let's go this way. Go murder some bunnies, yeah. Whip your sword out, love. Time for some murdering. Cha-pow! Delicious experience points! Don't run away from me, delicious experience points. That's also leveling up my cooking skill, as you can see in the bottom left. It's a cool system. What I like about it, though, it kind of stops you just, like, pointlessly grind. Like, remember back when we played Skyrim? Okay, no, none of you are going to remember this. But there was an episode where we made, like, 10,000 iron daggers or something like that. Just lots of iron daggers, right? Because it was the best, like, the most efficient way to level up blacksmithing. And it's, I don't know, like, having no limit on it just meant I could just grind out these iron daggers and get max blacksmithing and then get gear that maybe I shouldn't have been able to get. Whereas this system kind of stops that, right? There we go, cooking went up. What do we get, what do we get, what do we get? Spiced meat, the most delicious of the meats. Once I murder this dude, maybe I'll level up. No, but nearly. We do need water. We're a little. Oh, what's that? What's going on over there? It's a wolf. I feel I should stay away. And yet I feel myself walking towards it. What an interesting predicament. It's massive. I kind of want to see it, right? For the sake of the screenshot for the thumbnail. And now I want to run away. Ah! Jukes! Wah! Okay, this is fine. I can fight this. Be gone, fiend! Yeah! That's the stuff. Harvested the hell out of that wolf, we've got to say. Right, we're a little bit tired, but we've leveled up. That's going to give us loads more stuff we can do now, including, more importantly, we can potentially get ourselves a little house. We're going to relax at the end of the video. We'll head towards down to the river, grab ourselves some water, just try not to die, basically. And then maybe we'll come build out here a little bit, just out in the sticks a little bit. Or just a little straw house, just something to get us by before we can head off. I think the water, well, assumedly if we go downhill, right, we'll find, yeah, look, there's a little lake here. I really thought that wolf was going to kick my ass, in all honesty. Oh, bloody hell. Yes, I think I need a shave. What is that? Oh, it's a skeleton. It's a spooky, spooky skeleton. No, okay, I just sort of touch the water and it fills up my, nope. Okay. Screenshot. Now run away! What level are you? Oh, 64. Not interested. He's a little slow, which means I can recover my stamina a little bit. Go away! What is that? Is that a boar? Are you gonna murder me? I hope not. Hello? It's only level 4. The skeleton's still here! Ah! I really freaking... Oh, they're fighting. Okay. Ah, that's cool. Good for me. I'm gonna go grab my food. This fire over here should actually still have it. Unless it's all kind of died. Did it rot? Well, it's not here anymore. Oh, berries to make spiced meat. Okay. Nah, still got plenty on me. It's fine. There's 66 here, though. Bloody Nora. Maybe we should build around here. No, I can have my own campfire. That's fine. Okay, well, I'm feeling pretty good. Let's level up. Attack, I think. Oh, and health. I keep hearing noises. Like, I'm just tab back in quickly to make sure I'm not about to get murdered. Okay. So, if we go into knowledge, level 6 now, actually. Cooking is leveled up, so now we can get survival rank 2. Oh, we need survival rank 2 to get that. It shows you which ones you can actually get now, so we can get this now and get a house seal. Cool. Collect flowers to get a wooden signpost. Straw work. Right, harvest straw, harvest twine, build straw structures. That's going to get us a shabby foundation. And we can get all of this, but we'll have to keep leveling it up, I guess. And we can actually get fire magic now. Awesome. Loads of stuff to do, ladies and gentlemen. As I said at the start of the video, if we can hit 500 likes, not that many, hopefully, on this video, we will be back tomorrow. And our goal tomorrow, we're going to build a little hut, probably off just out there in the wilderness a little bit, and we'll try to get hold of some fire magic and start working towards the taming and stuff like that as well. I know I'm a little late to this game in general, you know, probably like a week late compared to most of YouTube, but honestly it's down to you guys whether you want to see more or not. That's all there is to it. If not, I'll get a refund. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye bye.